Here and Now, the program featuring the news and interests of the African American community. Here's your host, Sandra Bookman.
Still to come on Here and Now, a young woman who spent 6 years with six different families in foster care and now advocates for thousands of children in New York City. Her story next.
Stress and the fear of not having a permanent place to live, feeling like people don't want you, feeling unloved.
May is National Foster Care Month, the time set aside for foster care parents, mentors, professionals, and advocates to renew their commitment to children. More than 400,000 children across the country are living in foster care homes. With us today is a young woman who spent a portion of her youth in the foster care system and knows the challenges well. Terrell Starr now sits on the board of two organizations that advocate for youngsters in foster care, CASA NYC and City Living NY. So nice to meet you, Terrell.
Thanks for having me.
So how old were you when you went into the foster care system, and how did you end up there?
I was around the ages of 3 to 4, and the reason I ended up in foster care is because my great-grandmother, she just got too old to take care of me, and so I ended up in foster care. But, you know, the backstory to that is that I lived with my great-grandmother because my mom was using drugs at the time, and so I was living with my great-grandmother, and then when she got sick, I went into foster care.
And you were, how long? How long did you?
So foster care, again, the years are fuzzy because I was so young, but anywhere between ages 3 to around 11.
You were there.
Yes.
And if I'm incorrect, six different homes.
So a mix of what they call kinder care, so family placements, as well as foster care, so true, just strangers that you live with.
Yeah. And talk about the impact that had on your life. Is it something that it was just, you know, you'd be different if you had been able to be home with your family?
Yeah, so I always think about just sort of how my life has turned out and how much I've been shaped by my time in foster care. And it was a very difficult time going through foster care. One of the issues and challenges that youth face whenever they're in care, is really sort of dealing with the stress and the fear of not having a permanent place to live, feeling like people don't want you, feeling unloved. And so that has colored my entire life. As I moved through foster care and sort of went through school and sort of made my own home, my own family. And so it was just a very, very difficult time of feeling afraid all the time, of wishing that I could go home, but I couldn't, of not knowing what was happening around me to place me in these different homes. And so it was a very frustrating time, to say the least.
Mm-hmm. And you know, look, now you're a grown woman, so you're able to sort of vocalize what that was, and so you know what might make you feel a certain way and handle that. How do you deal with that and process that as a child so that it doesn't color everything you do the rest of your life?
It's very, very hard. One of the statistics is 1 1/4 foster care youth will suffer from PTSD, and that's a higher rate than our veteran population, and it's because of all the stresses that they experience while they're in care. And me, myself, I've had so many stresses and things that become triggers later in life that you just sort of don't expect, especially if you don't deal with them. Things about, how much to eat, how much not to eat, where you're going to sleep at night, going into strange homes, all bring up these memories that can sort of stress you and make you worry. And the way you deal with them is by talking about them. It's one thing I counsel a lot of the youth that I speak with is to talk about what they're feeling, talk about the emotions that they're having, so they don't bubble up and come out in the wrong ways.
And, you know, we're talking about how you were sort of dealing with all this and processing it. And the way you processed it, was that a result of the kind of home you were in sometimes? I mean, were all of the situations good? Were there some less than desirable?
Yeah, it was a mixed bag. So I had some really great homes, and I had some really terrible ones where I was abused. And so some that weren't better situations than the situation I got pulled out of. Mm-hmm. And so the way I dealt with those situations is learning sort of whether how to engage with my foster family or how to avoid them sometimes.
But you were so young and having to make that decision?
You have to make that decision. And these are decisions that youth are faced with when they're placed in these homes. And so you have to sort of figure it out and learn how to deal with what's right in front of you. And so one of the ways that I was able to sort of break away, especially when I was in negative homes, was that I always loved school. And so school sort of became my resource. It became the place where I felt safe. And so I'd spend as much time at school as possible which sort of set me on the path to sort of where I am today. But not every youth has that sort of opportunity right in front of them, especially when, you know, their foster parents may not be pushing them at school. They're not getting the care they need. Yeah. And so just making sure that they have sort of outlets just helps so much.
What would you change about the system?
I would change a lot about the system, but one big thing I would change about the system is making sure that the youth, when we are taking them out of these homes, we're taking them out of these homes for the right reasons. A lot of people believe that youth are taken out of these homes because of either the youth is a bad child or because they're being abused. And the truth is, no youth ends up in foster care because they've done anything wrong. It's the people around them that may not be able to support them correctly. And a majority of youth actually don't end up in foster care because of abuse. They actually end up in care because of neglect. And how we define neglect in this country tends to be very disproportionate depending on the race that you are. And so if you are African American or a person of color, you are four times more likely, those youth are four times more likely to end up in foster care than of other races. And so one thing I would change is making sure that one of the reasons that they end up in care, it makes sense. Parents, children are taken away from parents because they can't provide adequate food. They might lose their job. They might live in an unsafe environment, a safe apartment, a safe home. And so those are all things that could be dealt with in other means than taking a child out of the home.
So people, in a sense, are being penalized for having less.
For being poor. You're being penalized for being poor. You're being criminalized for being poor. And it's the youth who end up dealing
paying
with the situation,
paying the price.
And
your concerns for other youngsters who find themselves in the situation is one of the reasons that you work with the organizations that you do. So talk to me, because I know that while they're both organizations, advocacy organizations for the foster care system, they do slightly different things.
Yes.
So CASA NYC, that organization works with kids that are in foster care, the system right now.
Exactly.
Right?
So CASA NYC works with youth currently in foster care. And essentially what they do is, you can basically sum them up, they are volunteer social workers to sort of sum up everything that they do. But they are appointed by a judge who recognizes that the youth who happens to be in his courtroom may fall through the cracks, may need extra support that they're not getting either from their foster parents or from the group home. And so CASA sort of plays this volunteer social worker role where they'll come in and help possibly the parent find a job, maybe find a better place to live, a safer place to live, so the child can be reunified with them, actually speak on behalf of the youth and to help them get through school, resources they may need, books, glasses, any of those small things that normally fall through the cracks for a lot of youth. And so CASA plays a very big role. They actually support about 1,000 youth here in New York City, and there's about 12,000 youth in care, so they're helping just a fraction of them, and they'd love to help more, but it's just one small way that they're able to lend support.
To give back. And then City Living NY, which really is so important, is really focused on youngsters that are aging out of the system, and many of them, they have no one.
They have no one. A lot of times they have no place to go. So City Living NY actually helps youth who've aged out of foster care. And if you are 18, 19, 21 years old, and you're aging out of care, the one thing that you really need is a place to live. And City Living really helps with providing those additional resources for youth who are moving into their first apartment. Mm-hmm. When you move out, you do get a very small amount of money, but usually doesn't even cover a mattress. And so how do you cover first month's, last month's rent?
Yeah.
How do you actually outfit your home to make it a safe space and safe environment? And a number of the youth that City Living supports are youth who are also trying to work. They're trying to go to school. And so all these other things that they need to gain self-sufficiency, City Living tries to provide that for them. And so these are two amazing organizations that are helping youth at both ends of the spectrum while they're in care and then when they age out.
Yeah, and you are really, I love the way that you really are looking out for other youngsters that through no fault of their own have found themselves in the situation. And I want to talk a little bit, I got a minute or so left to talk about your blog, Not Just a Girl in a Dress.
Yeah, so I started this blog about 6 years ago, and it's a lifestyle blog where I cover technology, I cover beauty and fashion, basically all the things that I've always been curious and that I've always loved, I sort of cover on the site, and it's sort of opened so many doors for me, not only to sort of use my platform to speak on behalf of foster youth, but also just to sort of share my interests with sort of my followers and my readers.
You are aptly named Shwell Star.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Thank you for coming on the show. CityLivingNY.org and CASA in-nyc.org.
Yes.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.